Then, for the acceleration, we have a couple important exercises. Water, fibrology, sleds, monster hand acceleration, and reverse acceleration. So, I'm going to ask you for help again. Position yourself against the wall. It's very popular attacking drill. Good angle, a little bit more back. A little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit lower. One foot up. Perfect. And now the switch. You know the drill?
Yes.
Perfect. Okay. You know the drill. So it's one of the key exercises to teach the acceleration position. And later on you can do it against me. So play against me. Perfect. Good. Or we can go with it. I'm gonna resist it. Go. Okay? It's ball drill the first, the most basic one, then you have partner match. Now we don't have the sleds, but that's why I put the photo. The sleds you know, good positioning with lighter weights, so you can do it explosive. Later on you can put a lot of weights, but sleds would be good. And then later on, one of the jump, you run, and you jump to stop. So how he used heels. Nice. Four foot to decelerate, to use the brakes and use a good core position. Next, we have end of stuff. You run and then in the last moment you turn with foot perpendicular to the direction of the top. Yes, exactly. What he did, he lowered his body down, so it's one of the good ways. Then we have mount stop, which is a little bit more demanding regarding the quads and hamstrings. It's mount stop from here to here. You stop in a mount position. Core is very important.
Yes.
Okay. Much more demanding than this one. Okay. Then we have the reverse mount stop, which means running backwards. Now you run backwards and you stop from running backwards. You stop. That's it. Oh, stop. Okay, go once again. No worries. Oh. Now he did the regular reverse lunge. So bias reverse because you do reverse lunge. He did the regular, which is athletic, more safe by loading the Achilles and loading and being in much better position to change to sprinting forward. However, a lot of players also use the D type of stop with the open foot, which has certain risk for the muscles of adductor region and so on, but it's an option and players use it. So you can consider it. If you find it okay, you can use it. However, the regular one is always complete safe and it's better if you need to react straight forward. The close up is one of the most specific exercises for basketball. It's where to stop, like in a close up with chopping feet. Chopping feet is like a foot fire, boom, here, this way to stop. And it's increased frequency of steps with good core stability, you're able to stop very quick. Can you do one time? Let's go. Nice. To full stop and to have good position, I always say finish the jumping feet in the position where you feel comfortable to again to jump, to explode sideways, to run backwards. And you know, you always say when you decelerate and stop, you have a feeling of sensation that you have accumulated the energy and then you can do whatever you want again. Jump, run, move sideways, you know. It has to be powerful stop. Okay. The close up, the choppy feet, it can be done from like progression because it's not so easy, so it's very complex exercise. You can do one step, and then you go back, then you can go one, two steps. So what you're trying to do, by increasing the force that your body produces, you're putting more pressure on your core muscles and on the frequency of the chopped feet. So to go one, two, three, four, it's more difficult. Okay? And then what you need to do, regarding the specificity of the exercise, you can go chopping feet here to the middle, so you can open to the left or to the right or to the left side. Okay, or you can go chopping feet as he demonstrated immediately to one side, which means that I will go to defend you and I will go immediately to this direction because here we have help of our team. Okay, so it can be also pre-planned by positioning the feet in the desired direction. What are useful strength exercises? It's like an addition to stopping in this manner, close out. Use all the exercises that help you to resist the anti-flexion of the body. What kind of exercises? Vertical jumps, as we said at the beginning, if you have this position, then you have, of course, I exaggerate, but you get to get the point. But if you do this, then you have to change, reposition, and then start. So this kind of strength exercises, full body strength exercises, could be helpful. Or in the end, some kind of like lunge and medicine ball, boom, and you throw. Ballistic exercises. You go to the wall, and you hit it, boom, to the wall, then it bounces back. And you throw it, you know, to feel that something is pushing. Of course, you can do some kind of partner exercise, I'm going to push it, and then you just go one step forward. Okay, it's perfect. It's one of the exercises that I use very, very often before the game, or they do it in pairs to prepare for the practice. You know, works well to activate glutes and hamstrings, prepares the core. You know, and it's very close to the specific demands. Agility, you can see it. The first one is the hip turn. It doesn't have to be like a jump, it just needs to be like a hip turn. Yes, that's it. Sometimes it's one of the key things, because when you're receiving the defense, you wait for here, and sometimes it's too slow to do this and open. So sometimes you need to do this. Okay? So it could be like one of the prior step, it could be one of the important things to teach. Reposition. Then we teach the shuffle. It's easy, perfect, okay. And now do easy and a little bit hard. Easy and hard, perfect. So with good mechanics, leading foot is always, it could be a little bit open because it's better surface to pull. So both legs work. Pull and push, pull and push. And body, it always looks like a stable ball. Okay? It's never. When you see the player moving like that, it's probably dead. He's losing the energy for that. So both legs need to work in defense, and usually it's even better. For example, when you move ballast and not when someone comes, you receive an offensive ball. So, teach how to shuffle. Start easy, easy to hard, and hard. And then you can approach someone here. And then when somebody shuffles well, with good technique, we say put the hand above your ankles and perform the same shuffle. Maybe you will have a little bit more narrow position, but it's okay. Okay? Go back. And you can see that he's using both legs. Leading one to pull and this one to push, and then he has the upper body well balanced. Okay? So shuffle with mini bands. Then shuffle with monster band, which is quite a unique exercise. Now we're gonna see. I'm gonna connect you like this so we see how it's gonna work. It doesn't have the. You try to move. I'm gonna rotate you a little bit. Let's go. Oh, that's the basic thing. Once again, especially this one, because there is a lot of force coming from my side, the most important thing is that he doesn't change the technique. How he moves and how he uses his legs. If he has to pull with the upper body against me, it's bullshit exercise. Okay? So good technique, the same as it was, but he was not using the back. This is the most basic type of training. Work against the force. But sometimes, to improve the core activation, I'm going to pull him. Go. Pull him. Okay? And even you can do a few more shuffles and then you stop. Shuffle with good stuff, but he has to use the strength of here. It's going to be useful strength exercises. All of the work that resists the rotation, so he has to stay here, so he resists the rotation, and lateral flexion. Lateral flexion is this. So exactly with this exercise, we're going to do it. Or he can do the chops, for example, from here, or he can here, okay? And he can do as a young guy or angle chop. Both sides. He does like 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He gets the ball out, boom, boom, boom here, boom. He does without the ball. So he can get the feeling immediately with the ball and without the ball, how it improves the body posture. Okay? So it will be useful strength exercises for SAQ. Multi-directional training, we're going to finish with that. The exercises. Front to back, back to front. So, accelerate, stop, and run back. You can take it off, everything. While it takes off, I'm gonna demonstrate the first one. So, we say, accelerate, boom, stop, run back. It can be done alone, it can be competitive, it can be with dribbling. The progressions are somewhere far. Okay? It's the same exercise always, but with different goal. Because it's based on the training principle of progression. Okay? So the exercises are not so important as the progressions. Then, run back, as I showed, front to back, back to front. Run back, and turn, boom, to sprint. That's another multi-directional type of training. It's very nice for instability. Then, front back type of movement to lateral. So, the close-up or shuffle is this one. Front, boom, shuffle in, open, shuffle. Okay? Then, close out to shuffle and cross step. So you go front work, close out, shuffle, cross step. Because sometimes, if somebody needs to cover more space, he's not gonna go from jumping in, shuffle to come here. No. It's much more natural if he closes up. He says, shuffle, oh, I have to cover more space. Open up, boom. Much easier, okay? Then, sometimes it's normal in basketball that you run backwards, not too hard, but you realize that you need to shuffle. So it can be, So it can be one type of multi-directional work. If we consider moving front or back with lateral. Okay? Then, lateral work to front and back. It's very simple. You shuffle, move, and then you have to go forward, or you shuffle, move, and you start back pedal. Okay? So, we have to catch all directions. Lateral work with changes of direction and turns is very, very popular. Lateral shuffle, left, right. What does it mean? That we are not just moving to one side and we stop. No. We move and we change direction. Left, right. It's in one way, multi-direction. Zigzag defense is very popular. So you go from here to here. Okay? What is the key point in this kind of movement? How you position the feet. You remember that feet placement category, which is important. Here, boom, boom. Here, you pivot. And you have good biomechanical position. So you have to turn the foot. So, again, principle. Slow to fast. Slow. Turn. And then, increase the speed. okay? And then how the contact can be zigzag to turn and touch the rim. So you can make like from here, 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 and from here you turn and go to jump on the rim. It can be some kind of eccentric rim. Okay? Because it's very often the case. Defense, the guy makes a jump shot, and you go for it. No? So, what are the key points? Defense, good defense, low, here or low, he made a jump shot, or somebody else made a quick jump shot from this position, you don't go up. You turn, boom, and you have good position to take it. And finally, the hard turns, which are not so common, but sometimes in the fast break they can happen. The 180 turns, for example, you go running like crazy, and then you realize you stole the ball, then you have to go 180 turn. In this case, it's very important how well you go down and how well you pivot. Because it's even harder to pivot from the zigzag shot. Zigzag is 90 degrees or less of pivot, and the hard turn, 180 turn, it's much more.